Hello and welcome to an overview of the 2025 crop cost of production. My name is Darren Bond, Farm Management Specialist Crops with Manitoba Agriculture. Today I will be providing a summary and highlights of our annual crop cost of production budget guide. Topics today include how we compile the information for the numbers contained in the document, an overview of the 2025 crop cost of production including grain prices, profitability, break-even yields and prices. I'll also be discussing changes from our last 2024 crop cost of production budget guide, comparing our 2024 guide to our 2025 guide with a focus on fertilizer pricing. Finally, I'll discuss some key takeaways from this year's budget. Our crop cost of production budget guide is an annual guide produced at the end of each calendar year. When researching costs, we research much like from a farmer's perspective. We reach out to input retailers across the province to find common pricing for things like seed, fertilizer, and crop protection pesticides. With respect to fertilizer, we conduct surveys twice a year, in April and October. Crop insurance or agri-insurance costs are based on the previous year, with our guide's 2025 agri-insurance costs based on actual 2024 agri-insurance costs, as costs and coverages are released after the release of our guide. Costs like fixed costs can be quite variable across farms. With respect to determining land costs, we use Farm Credit Canada's Farmland Values Report data, along with Statistics Canada data on equity levels on farms in Manitoba. Based on this, we come up with estimated land payments for the sample farm in the document. Machinery costs are determined in a similar fashion using Statistics Canada data on equipment investment amounts and equity levels with equipment on farms in Manitoba. Finally, we have an owner's withdrawal amount and labor amount to represent withdrawals from the farm by the owner. Lastly, we add operating costs, fixed costs, and owner's labor and living costs to come up with an estimated total cost for 16 crops in the document. From there, we estimate average yields and a target price based on new crop fall 2025 delivery to conduct a profitability analysis. Before we dive into the document, it's important to have a brief overview on grain pricing over the last several years. This chart shows the average Manitoba crop prices per bushel from August 2020 to current prices in December 2024. It's important to remember that these prices represent weekly close and don't contain the interweek highs or lows or the intraday highs or lows for grain prices. As we can see with these four crops, hard red spring wheat, canola, oats, and soybeans, prices in late 2020 increased until mid-2022. Since then, grain prices have come down steadily. Let's zoom in and look at the last crop year and a half from August 2023 to date. Focusing in on August 2023 to December 2024 crop pricing chart, we can see that price deterioration continues. For example, canola was around $17 per bushel at the start of 2023 crop year. Currently, it's below $14 per bushel. Hard red spring wheat was around $10 per bushel at the beginning of 2023 crop year and is now around $8 per bushel. Oat pricing has held on relatively well with only a minor deterioration in crop pricing in this period. Here's our crop cost of production for 2025, showing the operating costs, fixed costs, owner labor and living costs, and total costs. Please note I'll focus on hard red spring wheat, canola, and soybeans later in the presentation to show the differences between the 2024 and 2025 costs and profitability. Moving down, we have the estimated farm gate prices for new crop fall delivery 2025, along with target yield and price based on Manitoba Agriculture Services Corporation's agri-insurance data for average yields in the province. As we can see at the bottom of the slide, marginal returns over total costs or net profit are projected to be in the negative for all crops shown here. In fact, of our 16 crops contained in the document, only pinto beans show a profit after all costs are considered. Also notice there's a pretty tight band with all the crops except barley with respect to losses per acre. These losses consider a fully costed cost of production. When I say fully costed, I mean fixed costs and owner's withdrawals are also taken out of this, which, as we can see here, is over $200 per acre. I would suspect farms that have higher equity levels will be able to generate small profits this year, where as new and beginning farmers or farmers that have expanded recently by way of debt will struggle to generate a profit this year. On this slide, we can see the break-even prices. For the five crops grown, break-even price is determined by dividing costs over expected yield. Break-even prices can be very useful. It helps with identifying market opportunities and also identifies the likelihood of profitability when we compare our break-even price to current market prices. As we can see here, hard red spring wheat's break-even price is $8.73 per bushel, oats is $4.40 per bushel, corn is almost $6 per bushel, canola's break-even price is $14.12 per bushel, while soybeans is $13.10 per bushel. This slide shows the break-even yields for the crops. Break-even yields are calculated by dividing costs over the expected price per bushel. Break-even yields can show the likelihood of generating profitability when one compares them to average farm yields seen on the farm. In 2025, using the information in our crop cost of production guide, break-even yields for hard red spring wheat is 71 bushels per acre, 128.9 bushels per acre for oats, 146.1 bushels per acre for corn, 47.9 bushels per acre for canola, and 44.1 bushels per acre for soybeans. This slide shows Manitoba Agriculture's crop cost of production numbers from 2020 to 2025 for hard red spring wheat, oats, canola, corn, and soybeans. As we can see here in 2022, costs jumped significantly for all crops, with 2023 having the highest cost of production, with costs easing off slightly for 2024 and a little more for 2025. While costs have eased off slightly, we can still see that they are historically high. When we consider the decline in the grain prices, crop input costs have not declined at the same rate as commodity prices, which is what is causing the cost price squeeze that we're currently experiencing. Now let's drill down and look at a few different crops, comparing 2024 cost of production to 2025 cost of production. Here, we're looking at hard red spring wheat. On the left-hand side, we can see the costing, with 2025 costs on the left-hand side and 2024 costs on the right-hand side. Some highlights of the changes include seed costs coming down about 6% compared to 2024. Fertilizer costs are down 9%. Crop protection pesticide costs are down roughly 11% compared to 2024. Fuel costs are down 21% per acre. And interest on operating costs are down roughly 24% per acre. It's important to note that while fuel costs and interest costs have declined significantly on a percentage basis, this represents only a small decline on a dollars per acre basis. Fixed costs are roughly the same from 2024 to 2025. This is because while machinery and land costs have increased from last year, interest costs on fixed costs have come down, essentially nullifying the land and equipment increase in costs. This is true for all land and equipment costs for the various crops in the guide. Total costs are down $38.69 per acre. With respect to projected pricing, price per bushel is down 14% from last year's guide. Margin over operating is down 20% per acre, with net profit being down $42.56 per acre compared to 2024. Focusing on canola, again on the left we see 2025 crop cost of production estimates, and on the right 2024 costs from our last year's guide. Here we can see canola seed costs are up 3% per acre for 2025, with fertilizer costs being down roughly 10% per acre. Crop protection pesticide costs are down roughly 12% per acre as compared to 2024. Much like hard red spring wheat, fuel costs are down 21% per acre, and interest costs on operating are down 23% per acre. This results in total costs being down $38.34 per acre. Using projected new crop fall 2025 delivery prices, we can see the price per bushel has decreased roughly 16% from last year's guide. Margin over operating is down 29% per acre, with net profit down $74.16 per acre. The 2024 guide projected a small profit, while the 2025 guide is projecting a $39.24 per acre loss. This next slide shows soybeans cost of production between 2025 and 2024, with 2025 being on the left and 2024 costs being on the right. Seed costs are unchanged per acre between the 2 years. Fertilizer costs are up 4% per acre, largely due to the amount of phosphorus required for soybean production. Crop protection pesticide costs are down roughly 8% per acre. Much like the previous two crops, fuel costs are down 21% per acre, and interest on operating costs are down roughly 20% per acre. This results in total costs being down $16.16 per acre. The projected price per bushel has declined between the 2 years by 21%. Please note that there has been a yield change, moving from 38 bushels per acre in 2024 to 40 bushels per acre in 2025. This is based on Manitoba Agriculture Services Corporation average yields in the province, which has been trending up over the last few years. Margin over operating per acre is down 33%, and net profit per acre is down $83.34 per acre, even considering the slight increase to projected yield. It's time to dive into some fertilizer analysis. This slide focuses on urea nitrogen. On the left-hand side in the bar chart, we can see the average urea prices over the last few years. When we conduct fertilizer pricing surveys, we conduct one survey in the fall for the next year's crop and one survey in the spring for that year's crop. The red bar is the previous fall, with the blue bar being the spring survey pricing. So for example, in 2024, we would have collected prices in October of 2023 and in April of 2024 to determine those prices. Generally speaking, prices are cheaper in the previous fall than that in spring. However, we can see that there is an inversion in 2023, with the spring pricing being considerably cheaper. On the right-hand side, the line chart shows fertilizer affordability, which is the amount of bushels of grain required to purchase 1 ton of urea. The top set of red lines is wheat, and the bottom set of blue lines is canola. Here we can see the dotted lines are the average amount of bushels of grain required to purchase 1 ton of urea. Looking at this data, urea is still slightly more expensive than average. While the price of urea has come down, the price of grain has come down even more, resulting in urea still being more expensive than average when we factor in the price of grain. When we focus in on phosphorus, we can see that phosphorus is still very expensive. The bar chart on the left is phosphorus pricing for the previous fall and spring. And again, we can see that in 2022, phosphorus pricing took a considerable step higher and has only come down marginally over the last couple years. When we consider the price of grain, looking at the chart on the right, we can see that phosphorus is very expensive. When we're considering the price of grain again, the line chart in red on the top is wheat, with the blue on the bottom being canola. The dotted lines are again the average amount of bushels of grain required to purchase 1 ton of phosphorus. We can see, as with both commodities, that phosphorus is very expensive when we consider the price of grain. There are some key takeaways from Manitoba Agriculture's 2025 crop cost of production. Doing your own cost of production is very important, especially in years like this, where there's a cost price squeeze happening. Identifying profitable crops when finalizing your crop rotation will be important this year, as is identifying marketing opportunities. Lastly, knowing your risk will be especially valuable this year. While operating costs are lower, profitability is also much lower. This is due in part to the current commodity prices that we're seeing and our fixed costs remaining high. Crop price volatility could still lead to some opportunities for profit. However, these opportunities may be less frequent and for shorter periods of time than what we're accustomed to. For example, when we were determining the projected price for new crop fall 2025 canola, prices ranged from $12 a bushel to over $14 per bushel during the month of November 2024, demonstrating this price volatility. Finally, maintaining yield will be very important in 2025 to protect the gross revenue per acre in order to pay for what we are projecting in 2025 to be stubbornly high input costs. That concludes the presentation on Manitoba Agriculture's 2025 crop costs of production. Should you have any questions, feel free to reach out to us by visiting our website at www.manitoba.ca/agriculture or our toll-free number at 844-769-6224. Follow us on X at mbgovag. Please check out our videos on YouTube at www.youtube.com/Manitoba Agriculture. For more information regarding agri insurance, please visit Manitoba Agricultural Services Corporation at www.masc.mb.ca. Thank you and good luck in the upcoming growing season.